بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. تبارك الذي جعل في السماء بروجا وجعل فيها سراجا وقمرا منيرا وهو الذي جعل الليل والنهار خلفة لمن أراد أن يذكر أو أراد شكورا وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما والذين يقولون ربنا اصرف عنا عذاب جهنم إن عذابها كان غراما إنها ساءت مستقرا ومقاما والذين إذا أنفقوا لم يسرفوا ولم يقتروا وكان بين ذلك قواما والذين لا يدعون مع الله إلها آخر ولا يقتلون النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق ولا يزنون ومن يفعل ذلك يلقى أثاما يضاعف له العذاب يوم القيامة ويخلد فيه مهانا إلا من تاب وآمن وعمل عملا صالحا فأولئك يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما ومن تاب وعمل صالحا فإنه يتوب إلى الله متابا والذين لا يشهدون الزور وإذا مروا باللغو مروا كراما والذين إذا ذكروا بآيات ربهم والذين إذا ذكروا بآيات ربهم لم يخروا عليها صما وعميانا والذين يقولون ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما أولئك يجزون الغرفة بما صبروا ويلقون فيها تحية وسلاما خالدين فيها حسنت مستقرا ومقاما قل ما يعبأ بكم ربي لولا دعاؤكم فقد كذبتم فسوف يكون لزاما.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We send blessings and salutations upon the one who was sent to us, the messenger, the best of creation, the most noble of all prophets, the one who was free as a human being from all imperfections, the one whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had blessed with the best of qualities, protected from all evil qualities from the beginning all the way to the end. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us goodness, to grant us the ability to follow the message of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask him also to send blessings and salutations upon all the companions of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his entire household, and all of those who struggled through the centuries in a way that today we are seated here and the deen has come to us. My brothers and sisters, it is important for us to appreciate the efforts of those who have struggled over the years and the centuries in a way that today we are sitting with Iman. And we too should be engaging in a similar struggle. The struggle is free from violence. It is free from extremism. It is free from hurting and harming others. But it is full of goodness, good nature, good character, good conduct, peace, security, stability. That is the struggle of Islam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to use us to spread this goodness. We all know that Islam has given so much importance to gatherings. These gatherings of a social nature or gatherings of a religious nature are given very, very much importance in Islam. A lot of importance in the deen that we follow, the religion that we follow. Take a look at Jumu'ah. Jumu'ah is a Friday where the salah or the prayer is not acceptable unless it is read in a group of people. Subhanallah. And it is something incumbent upon the males. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed it not only in the Quran, but made it clear even through the teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Amazing. Jumu'ah is so important. I need to meet the rest of the Muslims. I need to know what's going on. I need to meet the others and ask what is happening so that if there is someone in need, I can reach out to them. You are my brothers and sisters in Islam. I am a brother of yours. If I am going through a difficulty, you should at least try to pray for me. That is the minimum. You should at least feel for me. And perhaps if you could reach out to me in a better way, it would be good. But if I were unable to know what's happening to you, and I were unable, or if I was a person who did not know or was not bothered, can I be called a member of the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness. Jumu'ah is indeed something extremely important, but it is a broader scale. It is, for example, a larger circle. We have the day of Eid as well, where we gather, alhamdulillah. Let us not let the day of Eid go by without greeting fellow Muslims. Today, as-salam has become lil-ma'rifah. If I know you, I greet you. If I don't know you, goodbye. I don't want to greet you. I look at you and look away. Allahu Akbar. May Allah protect us from this. Did you know that the greeting of salam is actually a dua? It is a supplication made for the person you are greeting. May peace be upon you. Imagine, Allah, you are asking him, Ya Allah, grant peace to this individual. Allahu Akbar. The reason why we are at war with each other today is we are not genuine in our salam, even if we make it. And many of us would love to avoid the salam. You find some people to this day, you greet them, they don't reply. They say, this man is not a Muslim, this man. But ya akhi, I've got one sign of Islam, that's enough for you. Subhanallah. The rest is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah help us. May He make us love one another. We do not want the crisis in the Muslim ummah where the downfall and destruction of it comes from within. May Allah protect us from this. Really, protect your hearts, protect your souls, protect whatever you have. Protect it with goodness and understand that you need to look after it as an ummah, as an individual. We hold no weight, no value. But collectively, we hold a lot of weight, a lot of value. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the deeper understanding and give us the tolerance to fulfill that which He has placed upon our shoulders as a duty. So, where am I getting? The topic is, laugh out loud, we haven't yet laughed. Allahu Akbar. There is no laughing, it was somber. It started off very serious. The reason I started this way is because some time back we had a lot of time for each other. We would see each other, we would greet each other, we would talk, we would have a meal in the home looking at each other, greeting our parents, coming back. I recall when we got up first thing in the morning, we went to our parents and we greeted them, Assalamu alaikum. At night when we were going to sleep, we went to our mothers or our fathers or both of them, or the brothers and sisters, those of us who do have, alhamdulillah, and we greeted them, Assalamu alaikum. Today, if you went at night to someone said, Assalamu alaikum, they would tell you, you better come back early. Meaning, you know, where are you going? Subhanallah. Whereas you are going to bed, greet your family members. Those were the days. May Allah grant us the return to those beautiful days. We had time, we could sit with our mothers and we would just speak about anything and everything. Tell her how school was and what happened and my friends and everything else. And it was such a beautiful relationship and we had less problems. The problems were of a smaller nature and less in number. Subhanallah, this was the gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What happened to those days? There was a time when if grandma was sick, we actually went out to ask her, grandma, how are you? Today grandma's passed away, may Allah grant her Jannah. We haven't even attended the funeral. Really? May Allah grant those who still have their grannies alive, may Allah grant them goodness. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to fulfill the right and obligation on our shoulders that those grandmas and grandpas have. Subhanallah. A day will come when you're a grandma, you're a grandpa, if Allah wills and wishes. May Allah grant those who don't have offspring, offspring. Ameen. So this is Allah and He is testing us, really. You need to make the time. You need to drop whatever you have, no matter how important it is. There are times when you have to drop it completely. And the problem is today, we are filling the gaps that we have in our lives, the free time we have, with something that is not important at all. It holds no value. It has not benefited us. If anything, it has harmed us. Subhanallah. Be careful. Be careful how you use technology. It will make you or break you. Subhanallah. Be careful. We fill our lives with that which is irrelevant. I'm sitting with my phone. Instead of benefiting with it, I actually am causing my own destruction by this. Subhanallah. So these are the days where we are tested in a bigger way because of something good that has come into our hands that we are using in a bad way. If I were to ask you, is a mobile phone a good thing or a bad thing? I think all of us would probably agree that it's something good. I mean, technology. Who says it's a bad thing? Put up your hands. Okay, give me your phone, Habibi. Allahu Akbar. We're not prepared. You see, I told you. We might say it's a bad thing, but you're not prepared to give it up, which means something is good about it. So use it in a good way. Believe me, if I collected the phones, I would have had at least 200-300 phones, mashallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us. At least we laughed out loud once. My brothers and sisters, technology is not a bad thing. The way we use it makes it bad. Subhanallah. A knife is not a bad thing. If you were to use it to eat and perhaps to cut the food or to maybe perhaps to make something halal and so on. But if you were to use it to harm a fellow human, to harm someone, something, a creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you are the one who's responsible. You did something bad. You did something evil. Subhanallah. May Allah protect us and grant us goodness. Today we have the iPhones and mashallah the Samsungs. You know, Samsung, someone told me it was actually a Muslim name, Shamsun, but I don't know how true that is, mashallah. And they said over time, they actually did not have the tajweed. You see, tajweed, Allahu Akbar, you need tajweed, so you say it correctly. However, let me tell you that the same device, you can correct your tajweed through the device. Did you know that? You can actually have applications that teach you the tajweed, not pornography, Allahu Akbar. But today, take a look at the Muslim countries and the Muslims. I'd like to believe we are affected in a bigger way with the menace of pornography than others. Go and do your studies. I don't want to name countries. May Allah protect us. I have done so in the past and I thought I'd rather have made a dua than to have mentioned a name. May Allah grant us goodness. May Allah protect us all. Wallahi, pornography destroys you. There is no good part of it, not at all. It is only full of destruction. The sooner you get out of it, the sooner you will be able to lead a proper life. The more you fall into it, the more you have this derogatory outlook towards the opposite sex and you have a wrong feeling within you and you are unable to satisfy your own spouse. You are not happy because you want absolutely everything that does not belong to you and that which belongs to you, you don't want it. Allahu Akbar. That's what pornography does. And people get hooked to it. It is worse than a drug. It is worse than cocaine, to be honest with you, because it is so addictive. It destroys you from the top, from the brain. People don't understand. There are several researchers. One might argue that what you said is wrong. It's not worse than cocaine. To be honest, go out and research. And the researchers are showing different things. They destroy you from the top all the way to the bottom. You become a person who cannot concentrate in salah. You are trying to say Allahu Akbar and an image comes into your head. Allahu Akbar. What is that? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. Really, pornography is such that when a person continues in it and they repent from it, the repentance needs to be so strong and you need to occupy yourself with something very powerful, something that will definitely take your time in a way that you do not go back. Because if you have a free moment, your mind will want to take you back. You will have these withdrawals. And that what happens then is if you drop again, you will need to engage in tawbah once again. Be strong. My brothers and sisters, in a lot of cases, it's just a phase. It's a phase that comes and goes, but it better go quickly. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen us. May we and our offspring and the ummah not be from those who even need to go through it as a phase. It's not a need, not at all. It's something haram. But what I mean is, may we not even go through it, not even as a little phase. And those who have been tested with that, may Allah strengthen you. Brothers and sisters, don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah. Because shaitan comes to you after you've been hooked into pornography. And I'm only giving you this one example. We may give more examples a little bit later. But shaitan comes to you after you've been hooked onto pornography and tells you you are too far from Allah to turn to Him now. You are too far from Allah to turn to Him now. If that is what shaitan is making you feel, remember he's got a more solid grip upon you than Subhanallah, Allahu Akbar. He's got such a solid grip upon you, yet he is weak. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, إِنَّ كَيْدَ الشَّيْطَانِ كَانَ ضَعِيفًا. Indeed, the plot of the devil, very weak, very, very weak. It was weak, it will always be weak. But we become weaker and we allow someone or a creature who is weak to overtake us. Don't do that. This is why people look at social media and they start saying very bad. Wallahi, my brother, my sister, if it is coming between you and Allah, cut it out. If you are not disciplined, if you are struggling with discipline regarding social media, cut it out. If you have a problem with Facebook where it's causing your marriage, cracks in your marriage, or it's about to break your marriage, cut it out. That's the solution. Subhanallah. Those who are disciplined, those who know how to use it, those who are strict, those who know where to draw the lines, those are the ones whom, yes, we will say, use it in a beneficial way. That's what we are saying. Even with your mobile phone, trust me, if it is coming between you and your spouse, cut it out. Start using the landline once again. In fact, you will really be so delighted not to be having a phone ringing all the time. Some people struggle with headaches. There are some researchers showing, one wonders how true it is, that it causes cancer, it causes problems, it causes difficulty, hence the rise in cancer. May Allah forgive us. I don't know if that's true, but I have read it. And you ask people who stop using phones, for example, you know, some people are on the phone 25 hours of the day. Where they get the 1 hour extra, I don't know. I think they add on an extra battery after that. Have you seen those batteries? Allahu Akbar. 25 hours. Allahu Akbar. May Allah forgive us. And yet the person who's right in front of you, your father, your mother, the hadith says, at her feet is paradise. At her service is paradise. That's what the hadith says. Correct narration. Subhanallah. And yet, we are not at her feet. Allahu Akbar. What I mean is we don't even talk to her. She irritates us because someone who is just conning us is busy telling us how they love us. And someone who really loves us, such that they brought us up, we haven't yet told them, I love you, mom. Why? I'm too old now, I'm 45. How can I tell my mom, I love you, mom, I really love you, mom? What's wrong? That's your mother. You might make her cry if you say it at that age. Cry tears of joy, warm tears that roll down her eyes, but we don't have time for her. Guess what? Guys, can I tell you something? There is another guy on the other side whom you think is a girl and you're busy saying, I love you and I really love you. Show me your photos and do this. And he's busy sending you, you know, some actress's photos and you're saying, woo, I got her, man. Really, we are being conned by the mobile phone, by the devices we have, by Facebook and various other things. Have you not read the stories of people who have done this? People who have conned the young girls and they are busy thinking there's a young man, and when they finally meet, there's an old 73-year-old man who can barely walk. And he says, no, it was me. And if you try to run away, they become violent. Haven't you read these stories? There was one a few days ago in the newspapers and on the internet, the news feeds, about a person who actually traveled one continent to another in order to harm someone he met over the social media. Why? Just because she didn't want to marry the guy. Allahu Akbar. May Allah forgive us. We become too attached to that which we're not supposed to be attached to. So we struggle and suffer mentally, emotionally. Someone tells you, I love you, big deal, subhanAllah. Today everyone is saying, like I've said before, how many times have you written LOL without laughing? I've done it. You know, they told me, what does it mean? I said, la hawla wa la quwwata. Allahu Akbar. May Allah forgive us. Really. LOL. LOL. And you haven't laughed. So how many times would people be telling you, I love you, and they actually haven't loved you? They're just trying to get to you. They just want to use you. They will want to just have a little party with you. And next thing, they'll drop you out and they'll be telling another 50 girls at the same time the same thing. Yes, wallahi, it's happening. Ask the youth and they will tell you true. Not true? Okay, they shy to nod their heads. You can nod them after the cameras leave, inshallah. May Allah forgive us, really. Do not do that. Do not abuse people. They are someone's sisters, someone's daughters, someone's mothers, someone's, for example, aunts and so on, just like you have. You would not like your relatives to be abused. Why are you abusing others? Quite simple. That is the hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today in the Western world, they are teaching you to say, don't abuse a female. Before abusing her, think for a moment before getting there, before even thinking about that. You'd rather ponder over the fact that she is someone's sister. She could have been your sister. She is someone's mother. She is someone's daughter. Well, that's taken directly from the words of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, when a man came to him and told him, O messenger, I want to commit fornication. Wow. A'udhu billah. Then the LOL definitely stands for La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Allahu Akbar. Imagine, he had the guts and the courage. Well, the message was for us. He did not commit it, but he said the word. Perhaps he might have had the idea and he wanted help. And this is why, my brothers and sisters, reach out for help. And oh, you who are helping others, do not abuse them. Allahu Akbar. Oh, you who are helping others, do not abuse them. Today we have a sickness where someone comes to you for help, whether it is financial help, whether it is any other form of help, and we abuse the status Allah has given us, the wealth Allah has given us, to try and lure them into sexual misconduct or something of that nature, abuse them in some way. May Allah forgive us, really. May Allah strengthen us. Where is the ummah heading? Come on, we need people who have values. We need morals. So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam looks at the young man and says, hang on, come here. Would you like it for your sister? He says, no, I wouldn't, not at all. Would you like it for your mother? Someone does it. He says, no. Would you like it for your daughter? No. Well, they are all sisters and mothers and daughters of someone. So how would you? He says, I understand. I will not do this. Wallahi, I will never do this. Amazing. Today the West is teaching us something after they have slid into difficulty. But we have the ingredient from a long time ago. The Muslims lead a disciplined life. So disciplined that subhanAllah, if you are to follow true Islam, your problems will be minimized. Nobody's saying you won't have issues and problems. Those are tests from Allah. But they will not come in as a punishment. You will understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing. Amazing. So let me say something very, very important. Islam has the solution to your problem. The problem with us is we don't want to follow the solution. Imagine the doctor tells you, you need to drink this, it's a little bit bitter, but you need to have it morning, afternoon, evening. In fact, let me make it more interesting. The doctor says, you want to really be cured from this huge disease you have, you need to get up at 15 minutes past 2 every morning and have 5 spoons of this. Wallahi, you'll be getting up at 13 minutes past 2 and waiting another 2 minutes. As soon as it clicks 15, you'll be drinking it because you want cure. We need cure for the diseases of the heart. Salah is the beginning point, together with istighfar and asking Allah's forgiveness. Ask Allah's forgiveness. He loves you. He loves you so much. He created you. And He wants you to turn to Him. He has given you so many opportunities. So many people will come to you. You will hear it from so many different people. So turn to Allah. Don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the greatest. He loves you so much. But make sure that you turn to him before it is too late. Never ever be from amongst those who says, Islam has too many rules, too many regulations, too many restrictions, I don't want to follow them. Well, if you do that, then get ready to suffer the same way those who have quit have suffered. They have struggled. Take a look at those who do what they want. They do as they please and they think YOLO. I'm sure you've heard that. You only live once. That's what the youngsters say, YOLO. Every little while it comes back, YOLO, YOLO. They tell you, you only live once. Come on, let's go. To where? The party. Did you try out the drug? No, I haven't. Let's go. What are we doing? Sniffing glue. Allahu Akbar. Sniffing glue, you'll get stuck onto the devil. A'udhu billah. May Allah forgive us. Really. Don't even try it. There's no point in testing. Motor vehicle. MashaAllah. This is the one benefit of social media is we can have number plates here on WhatsApp and we can read them out to you, MashaAllah. We can even have photographs of the vehicles if you guys would like to see, SubhanAllah.
These are the vehicle numbers.
The vehicle numbers is that KI7003, MashaAllah, brother. There is a $1 million prize awaiting you outside. here we are. 4078. That sounds like a 40-inch screen. LG. Did you hear that? 4078. Then CAA8255, HE7661, KX9382, and KL2775. These are number plates of some very, very good vehicles that are about to be auctioned, mashallah. So if you'd like to save your car, inshallah, you can actually get up. And we will make dua for you. Like I said, we will make dua for you. May Allah bless those who have the courage to get up and move their cars. May Allah grant them goodness and their families and their spouses. And may Allah bless them in every way and their sustenance. And may they be able to afford another 10 vehicles like those with the condition that they park them in the right place. What more do you want me to say? My brothers and sisters, here we are. And we are just talking about how to use technology correctly. Have a vehicle. A car is a gift of Allah. It is modern technology, to be honest with you. So sophisticated. Why put it in the wrong place? May Allah forgive us, really. Why put it in the wrong place? So my brothers, mashallah, I see a few people have walked out. I hope they are the ones. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them all and bless us. May He forgive us all. So the point I was raising was, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed rules and regulations because He knows what we need for happiness. So if I think I only live once and let me do what I want, I'm going to pay for it. Because let me tell you, let me give you examples. Take a look at those who have had affairs just because they've got no values or they let go, they let loose. May Allah forgive us all for whatever we may have done in terms of sin. None of us are perfect here. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yes indeed, perfect. Like we said, free from defect from the beginning to the end, subhanallah. With us, we have all these defects and so on. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. But at the same time, never let yourself slip intentionally and you haven't turned back to Allah. Take a look at those who don't believe in Allah. They want to do what they want. So they'll come into marriage and say, you know what? I want you to sign a document here before you marry. What's the document? I will not cook. Put it down. Okay, you won't cook. I sign it. Every Sunday, I will go back to my father's house. Wow. Okay, let's compromise. Make it a Saturday. Every Saturday. What will happen? You go back, he's going to go to the clubs, isn't it? So you thought you were a big deal, but what happened? It resulted in something bad. It resulted in some, I'm just giving you an example. But people are doing this today. They are making conditions that are absurd. You know, if it's a condition that's still good enough to say, look, don't stop me from wearing my dressing and so on, and my duties and what have you and whatever else in terms of goodness, mashallah, fair and well. But at the same time, those who are doing things that are harmful, the harm will come back to you. You know, you think, okay, what's wrong with a party? It's just a leavers party at school. What's wrong with it? And dad says, look, don't go. Or you can go, but let's make sure it's disciplined. Let's make sure, come back at a time. Let me come with you. Allahu Akbar. Mom says, let me come with you. Let's go together so that I can monitor. I don't need monitoring. You think I'm a child? Wallahi, how many girls from very good homes have come out of those dances and those parties pregnant? May Allah forgive us. Really, it's happening. Good homes. People are struggling and suffering. They have perhaps not discussed it with others. But trust me, it was just that little party. It took 2 minutes, 5 minutes. And next thing, the whole life was changed. We are not saying it's the end of your life. No, we are not saying the person was bad. But we are saying, look at what one slip can do in terms of change of your life. It changed. I'm in no ways judging people. But what I am saying is, when we slip, we pay. What type of payment? Well, perhaps Allah chooses. Some people have a payment that is much more higher in price than others. Take a look at some of the heroes and heroines of today on the television and so on. Look at their real lives. Don't look at the lives on the screen. That's just a show. Anyone can act. I can act. Anyone can act. I'm sure you can all act, you know. But take a look at the real life of the person, and you will find that it is disaster upon disaster in most cases. Most cases. And this is an honest opinion. In most cases, it's a disaster. It's not something worth following. And guess what? The mobile phones we have, the applications we have, the relationships we have, the Facebooks we use, the Twitters we use, and various other things we use, the Fourscores we use, and whatever else, the Meet and whatever else it's called that we people are using, a lot of it is giving opportunity to people to act. That's all. They're acting. They are pretending whom they are not in real life. Do not just see what is photoshopped. Don't just see a photo that is perhaps, you know, completely changed and edited, because like we say, you want to be like the girl on the TV. Well, you won't be able to be, because even the girl on the TV is not like the girl on the TV. You know what that means? Herself, she doesn't look like that. It's just completely, you know, five layers of makeup and so on, and she's just pretending like she's so happy, and when she goes home, she's so sad and angry and upset, and she doesn't even want to go home. And you want to be like her. Oh, that's my heroine. But look at the real life of the person. Real life. If you had to interact with them for a day, you would get irritated. And this is what's happening in our marriages. We meet someone on the internet. I'm not saying it's wrong, but I'm saying the way the follow-up is done is perhaps wrong in a lot of cases. If the follow-up is done correctly, where you get responsible people involved to meet the person physically and to try and check up who they are and what they stand for, perhaps it can work, and it has worked. But take a look at the bulk and what's happening. You meet someone and you allow yourself, you know, you allow yourself, subhanallah, to be released to that person. In what way? So the father will tell you, my daughter has not left her room. She's such a pious child. And here comes a proposal and she says no. And the father says, well, she's a very pious child. She doesn't leave her room. She does not go out of this house. Today, you can commit sin under your blankets in the darkness when there's no even electricity. Believe me, because your mobile phone is still working. A sin is committed. How? Person gets involved. It starts off in different ways. And then you've got a problem at home. And this is why we say, strengthen your relationships with your children, with your family members. So when they have a problem, they can talk to you and you help them out of it. Don't scold at your child and shout them and abuse them just because they've done something wrong. No, help them. Because if you abuse them, they will seek comfort over the phone with someone anonymous who's going to be a predator, who's going to actually harm them more than anything else. But they don't know any better. But at that moment of, you know, low, for example, when you're feeling low, or you have this low self-esteem, low morale, so to speak, and someone comes and tell you, wow, you're gorgeous. Trust me, they don't believe you're gorgeous. Well, a day will come when they say, I never thought you were gorgeous. I just told it to you to trap you. Allahu Akbar. May Allah not make us from amongst those who fall for this. So a person can commit a sin from their phone and you won't know. They've allowed themselves to be released to an anonymous person. And this is happening in our homes. May Allah protect us and our offspring. And then you find the, if they have the courage to confess to you that, okay, I'm in love with this person. And sometimes you hear something weird. Who is this person? Hey, Dracula from somewhere. Allahu Akbar. Where is this person from? You know the tricks of James Bond? He cannot do them in real life. Did you ever know that? Allahu Akbar. This is just an act. It's just a movie. They're busy telling you things that are not real. They're making you feel nice, so you're feeling big. And what happens? Sometimes, or you know what? When parents are strict, then the people come to us and say, ah, my father's disagreeing. No reason. This man reads his salah. This man is a good Muslim. This man has this. This man, you know, he served the deen and he's such a good man. My father's just rejecting for no reason. How do you know he reads his salah? He just told you. Have you lived with him? Did you see him getting up for Fajr? Have you seen things? Allahu Akbar. You know, that having been said, I need to address this issue very importantly. My beloved fathers, who are seated here. Do not be unreasonable when it comes to the marriage of your daughters. Don't. The worst thing that is going on today is when a daughter is married off and 5 years later, 10 years later, she tells her husband, I never ever wanted to marry you. The guy I wanted to marry, my father did not want me to marry. So I ended up fixed with you. Trust me, you, my beloved father, share part of the blame. Don't be unreasonable. Sometimes you've got to allow your kids to make a little mistake, something you think that is not ideal. Talk to them, convince them. I'm not saying don't try to present your opinion. Present it, try and convince them, give them the time, give them a chance. And if they're still adamant and so on, after explaining to them, sometimes it might be, not all the time, but sometimes it might be worth your while allowing them to go into something that you consider not ideal. Who knows, it might work. It might be something better than you thought. And if it doesn't work, they're still your daughter, they're still your child, they will come back to you and love you and embrace you. And you don't have to rub the salt in to say, I told you, I told you, because that's what parents like to do. Parents love to do this, I told you business. And nowadays, elder brothers and others also like to do the same thing. I told you, anything happens, I told you. So this is why there was a young boy who came to his mom and he says, Mom, you're gonna tell me I told you. Mom says, what happened? Well, I'm not telling you. So thereafter, like I was saying, the worst thing is for someone to come up years later and tell you, I never ever wanted to marry you. I loved someone I met on Facebook and you know what? I really wanted to marry them. But my dad said no, so I'm stuck with you. This is why we say, my brothers, my sisters, understand the nature of the social media. It can make you or break you. I'm not saying that there are no successful marriages of people who have met online. No, there are some websites that do assist in this regard. And although there was great animosity at the beginning regarding embracing these websites, the scholars are slowly, with lots of restrictions, assisting in this regard because it's become as difficult as it is to marry the right person. The choices have really expanded, and at the same time we have technology that can help us achieve something. But remember, there are crooks as well on the other side. There are foxes, there are cheats on the other side, there are vampires on the other side as well. Could be. This is why I always say, when someone sends you a friend request, be careful, vet them. You know what, I'm very sad to say something that has now happened. There was a time when every person is considered innocent until proven guilty, right or wrong? Today, we would still believe the same because the law cannot change. Although some countries might look at it another way and they're slowly trying to change their law, maybe not written, but the law is beginning to become everyone is guilty besides those whom we think are not. However, when it comes to us, we still believe everyone is innocent until proven guilty. When it comes to social media, for your sanity, for your goodness, be skeptical of every single person that wants to develop a relationship with you. Be skeptical does not mean they are guilty. It means watch out. Anything could happen. There are people who are abusing it. So many people collect money using the names of scholars and using the names of others, and they have nothing to do with it in reality. The person himself has nothing to do with it. So it's quite easy to make a page using a name of someone else and then pretend to befriend others and pretend to say, you know what, we have this cause and that cause and we are collecting money. To be honest, it's up to you to verify. If you didn't, it's your fault. Same applies marriage. And this is why lots of marriages are breaking, because when you end up living with the person, 3 days is more than enough to figure them out. 3 days. You already start feeling uneasy. Oh, I thought this person was really good. Look at this. 3 days and you're already fed up and you got to lead a whole life with them. This is why when you're getting married, tell yourself 100 times, I'm going to spend the rest of my life with this person. Am I really sure about it? Tell yourself, I'm going to spend the rest of my life with this person. Am I really sure about it? We are human beings. We are not chameleons who can change every day. One day this wife, another day that wife. People are becoming fed up of themselves. So what they do, they start swinging. I don't know if you've heard this. It's happening in some nations at the moment where people go to a party and they swap wives because they're fed up. Guess what happens? Shaitan penetrates the home And shaitan comes and affects the person. A dirty person is whom shaitan attacks. Then this person starts seeing things. Then they start hearing things. Then they become literally enslaved by the devil, because the jinn is around everywhere they are. They are affected by the jinn and they don't even know. And sometimes it becomes clear to them. Those who have made tawbah and turned to Allah have come out and confessed that this is the type of life we've led. And now that we found Allah, we are so happy, we are so good. You know, another issue, for example, very big disease. We love to take photographs of ourselves and put them up in a way that people are not supposed to be looking at. What this means is, okay, if there's a photograph, for example, within the limits of the Sharia, alhamdulillah, but you have women, you know, they want to show themselves in the greatest of beauty. Like I've just said, two things happen. One is the makeup, which covers you completely and makes you look, mashallah, so gorgeous. And you know that when you look in front of the mirror without that makeup, you're actually quite depressed. May Allah beautify our women and our men, mashallah. Mashallah. And secondly, on top of that, you've actually photoshopped the picture. So you look like a cartoon character, mashallah. Flawless. Allahu Akbar, flawless. And what happens? We put up these pictures, we have profile pictures, and guess what? When people say, you look gorgeous, we say, Jazakallah khair. You look gorgeous, and we're saying, may Allah reward you for what you've just said. Come on, the man is saying it for a reason. Why did you have to show yourself? And if you have a close group, your family and so on, it depends. Obviously, we know the limits. We definitely do know the limits, but we forget them. We don't think about them. So think about it carefully, because many marriages are breaking. You have a wife who's starting to be praised by anonymous men across the globe and even by the friends of the husband. And what happens? Next thing you find them in bed, and that's the complaint that we have today, that this woman ran away with her husband's best friend. How many stories would you know? May Allah forgive us. We're not judging the people, but we're saying it is a crisis. It is a problem that causes disaster upon disaster. And where did it start? With a few photos on Facebook. And then we have the leg showing. And then we have the arm showing, we want to show the chest and we want to show everything else. And subhanAllah, before it was only the food, now it's the cook as well. Allahu Akbar. Now I recall a statement made by one of the youth when he saw food. You know, some of the youngsters, they just want to eat. When you get slightly older, you appreciate what it looks like. You see the little design on the food and you say, oh, you know, the person's a little bit more mature. But young age, you just whack it. Whatever's there, you eat it. Your burger, burger. It must taste nice, alhamdulillah. Allahu Akbar. So a person tells me, you know what? Ooh, this food looks gorgeous. I wonder what the person who cooked it must be looking like. So I told him, oh, there's the chef. And he was a fat guy with a long, big hat. He says, how are you? I said, there you are, mashallah. May Allah forgive us, really. This is the internet. This is what it does to you. Your imagination races well beyond your capacity of running. This is something you need to know. Your imagination races well beyond your capacity of running. Your imagination, you cannot keep up with your own imagination. This is what happens. Why? Because it's beautified. Whoa, you see this. Trust me, if you saw this brother in real life, you would not even want to look at him twice. Obviously, with all due respect, but I'm using the term brother because we don't want to use the word sister. But sometimes people pretend like, oh, gorgeous. Be honest. Hey, look, this is me. Normal, general me, and that's what it is. Subhanallah. Don't try and impress beyond who you really are. So taking photos and putting them up, yes, sometimes it's something good. You've seen something, mashallah, you want to share it with the others. You've had something important, you want to share it with the others. It's important for you to share it with others if it's a good message, because let me tell you something of prime importance. In the same way that you can use media, the social networking and social media, to earn paradise very quickly, quicker than before. Did you know that? Before, if I were intending to talk to 1,000, 2,000 people, it would only be possible here, like for example, a hall of this nature. Mashallah, we've got several thousand here this evening. Alhamdulillah, may Allah accept us all. But today I can speak to 1,000,000 people. Before I know it, 20 million, 30 million. Subhanallah, how? If I put up something interesting, even if my account is unknown, something interesting, the whole world, it reaches the world. If it is good, you get a good reward. If it is bad, your sin is multiplied.
وَلَيَحْمِلُنَّ أَثْقَالَهُمْ وَأَثْقَالًا مَعَ أَثْقَالِهِمْ
Allah speaks of others, but the lesson is for us as well.
They will hold the burdens, their own burdens on the day of judgment, and the burdens of many others, they will hold them on their own shoulders. So one reads the Quran and says, is there no contradiction here? The contradiction being, one place Allah says, you will never shoulder the burden of another. And in this verse, Allah says, people will be holding burdens and the burdens of others. It's a simple explanation. You never ever hold the burdens of others unless you are connected to that burden. Unless you were a person who caused that, then you are responsible. So this is why we say, may Allah forgive us, how you use your Facebook is very important, and how you use WhatsApp is extremely important. Whatever else it is, nowadays there are so many different platforms, if I were to read them, we'd be here for 1 hour, and I still wouldn't have made justice to it, or done justice to it. So whether it's Viber, or WhatsApp, or Telegram, or anything else, you know, Skype, or Tango, or Mango, whatever else it is.
Mashallah.
We need to be responsible, because the people are divided into several categories. There are some on either extreme, or a lot are on either extreme. Some would say, no brother, just use it, man, come on, have fun. Have fun. Fun. F-U-N. You know what it stands for? May Allah forgive us, really. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. We think it's just a moment of fun, not realizing it's destruction. How long does it take to destroy your life? Take a look at some of the international personalities whose lives have been destroyed because of one nude photograph that they sent someone as privately as they thought WhatsApp was. WhatsApp is not private, not at all. Anyone can dig up your entire history of WhatsApp if they're ready to pay a little bit of money. That's what I was told. Allahu Akbar. So don't think it's private. Anyone can pick up on it. Your history, everything, whatever you've done on YouTube, whatever you've watched on your computer, whatever was ever seen, your Wi-Fi hotspot is registered, and you know the websites you've gone to, it's known. And guess what? While you were busy watching the porn, may Allah forgive us, they were busy photographing you without you knowing. You were being videoed. It's quite easy to turn on remotely a video on a phone. And even on a PC. A PC is even easier. Did you ever know that? Well, if you didn't, and if you're doubting what I've just said, go and Google it. And you'll see. This is why once I saw a man, and he actually had stickers all over his phone in the front and the back. I told him, what's going on? He said, I don't want anyone to take videos of me. And that's when I learned about it. I said, oh, are you sure? He says, yeah. Okay, that might be another extreme. But at the same time, we've got nothing to hide. We should never be people to hide. People who have something to hide. We should never be people who have something to hide. I've got nothing to hide. If you want to search, you search and you carry on and you go for it. Allahu Akbar. But take a look at how some top personalities have dropped. I'm sure you've seen the news of late. There are people who've done things some time back, and guess what? They are being nabbed because they did not use technology correctly. They allowed their lusts, their desires to overtake them when it came to the use of social media. This is what happened. So mashallah, when have we used our phones to contact our brothers, our sisters, to solve problems, to invite people towards goodness? When have we used our Facebook and our Twitter to retweet something of goodness so that we can get a reward for everyone who's seen that message? We are building our paradise in a far more easy way than those perhaps just before us. Why? Because we have opportunities that they did not have. Today you can reach 1 million people, like I said, whereas others would have struggled to reach out to even 1,000. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us. But their intentions were far greater than ours. They were far more sincere than us. This is why a small droplet of what they've done is better than us. Let's take a look at the statement of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam regarding the Sahaba. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum, we cannot compete with them. لا تسبوا أصحابي فوالذي نفسي بيده لو أنفق أحدكم مثل أحد ذهبا ما بلغ مد أحدهم ولا نصيفة. Do not speak bad about any one of my companions. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, for I swear by Allah, if you, any one of you, were to spend gold equivalent to the weight of Mount Uhud, which is a massive mountain in Medina Munawwara, it would not be equivalent to a handful of what they spent, or even half a handful. It's the sincerity, it's the timing, and everything that Allah intended, the value was far greater. But Allah's blessed us with opportunities. Use the opportunities. Your mobile phone will bear witness for you or against you on the day of Qiyamah. So use it in a way that you will be proud of it coming up and saying, "This I was only used by this man or this woman to spread goodness and to do something good." Like I said, we don't have time to phone our mothers, but we've got time, hours on end, for these free calls to people who are just conning us how much they love us. The day marriage comes, they'll run away. It's happening. You tell a man, if you're serious, come talk to my father. And he says, wait, wait, give me a little bit of time. What time? Time to just take you to bed, deflower you and walk out. A'udhu billah. This is what is happening. I'm not ashamed of saying it because it's a reality. Protect yourself from it. One of the most powerful things that you have is your iman. It's a gift of Allah. And the discipline that comes with it is only to protect you. Nothing else. It's only to save you from the dunya and the evil of this world as well as the evil of the next. Allahu Akbar. So don't let people fool you. Really. And then when it comes to the day, you say, look, I'm giving you a deadline. If you're not going to come to talk to my dad by this time, then I'm sorry, I have to move on. And you know what, in your heart, you really want him to come. He never ever had an intention to come, not at all. And what, he'll blame you on top of that. You're putting pressure on me. Are you putting pressure on me? I'll go away. Don't put pressure on me. Say, okay, okay, I'll give you one more month. You're still putting pressure on me. What's all this? How can you make yourself so cheap? For what? Tell the man, you come, you talk, then we will speak. This is how it should be. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us and strengthen us. Really, we cry tears. We become depressed. We become sad. We stop eating. We lose our health based on a relationship that went sour, that was never really there. We thought that it was there. The other party always knew it wasn't. And they pretend to you that they're struggling and suffering when they are not. This issue of pretense, it is really something that happens on social media. Social networking. Allahu Akbar. And this brings me to another point. And that is, my brothers and sisters, the profiles we have, what we write about ourselves, let it be something respectful. Let it be something decent. Who we tend to follow, who we tend to retweet, who we tend to, you know, share the statuses of. Make sure it is someone responsible who's saying something good. You don't want to arrive on the day of judgment and having lost just by one inch, lost the success of paradise. Just by one inch lost. Why? Because I retweeted some nude girl who was perhaps calling people towards evil. Look at the swear words that are flying around. People have no shame to use the most derogatory terms on Facebook and Twitter, and they get 100,000 retweets. Allahu Akbar. When we say Quran and Hadith, no one wants to retweet. The minute you say the speech of someone else, there's a few more retweets. The minute you talk nonsense, there is a lot of retweet. And the minute you swear, it's complete. It's like the whole world is cheering you on. Carry on. The swear word is still too light. Think up another one. A'udhu billah. You have people who show photographs that are full of nudity and haram. And that which really, when Allah tells you to lower your gaze. And how it's worded in the hadith is powerful. When we are told, lower your gaze, the gaze is a spear from the spears of the devil. Wallahi, it's exactly that. If you have seen something that your gaze was not lowered for, and you were not supposed to see it, and you looked at it a little bit more, what happens? The image stays in your hard drive at the back. In the hard drive at the back. And what happens? It keeps coming, recurring. You want to do something about it. You know, those who are involved in pornography at one stage, if they don't help themselves by coming out of it and engaging in tawbah, and they go further, it doesn't just stop at a watching stage. Now you want to act. Now you want to perform. They start recording themselves engaging in those type of acts. And what happens? Somehow, someone, somewhere gets it out of your phone. And sometimes you might share it with someone you think is your boyfriend or your girlfriend, and next thing it's online, and you don't know where to hide your face. You become suicidal. May Allah forgive us. So don't do that. It is silly. It is actually stupid. May Allah forgive us. It is something absurd, but people doing it does not make it right. Perhaps they have nothing to live for. We have the deen, we have respect and responsibility, high morals and values, because we want to lead a life full of goodness and happiness. We don't want to lead a life whereby every other, you know, Everything wrong is happening and then we lose our happiness itself. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen us all. Really, we are at an age where we are so fortunate to witness technology. You know, you have the phone, mashallah, it has a lock. The lock with a thumbprint and so on. It's now old. It's actually old technology. And it's come onto the phones, it's come onto various other things. Mashallah, we are witnessing face recognition and everything else. So good, alhamdulillah. But at the same time, my brothers and sisters, that very technology is being used carefully to degrade and drop the ummah. People are trying very hard to drop us. And this is why every time, even if you're opening your email, or sometimes you're opening just a normal page, you have an advert. What do they advertise? Adult friends, something of that nature. Something about adults. And the inquisitive mind might want to say, okay, you know, I'm a good man, let me just click. Watch out. That first click is where you go wrong. Don't let that inquisitive mind make you drop, because I tell you what can happen. People can later on check your history one day when they want to nail you for something and say, well, this man has been doing this and this and this, and they've got it all down, and you like gulping to say, how do they know? And sometimes they could be lying. How do you know? How do they know? Allahu Akbar, how do we know? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really protect us. So sometimes we're just inquisitive and we end up doing one thing. You know, some youngsters who've spoken to me, and a lot of youngsters are very good at heart. They have a problem sometimes of a different nature. Some of them have the problem of pornography. And you know what they tell you? They say, you know what? It's just like some magic that's happened on me. It's like I just click and before I know it, 5 hours have passed. Internet is used, money is used, everything happens, and 5 hours later I'm feeling so weak and I haven't slept. And now it's the time for Fajr, and just before Fajr I go to sleep. So I've missed my Fajr and everything has happened and that's gone. Sleep deprivation because you did not know how to use your phone. My brother, my sister, a lot of us, myself included, need to put our phone aside and switch it off and say, listen, the world can wait, I need to sleep. Allahu Akbar. I need to sleep because the phone is so magnetic, so sweet, so beautiful, so nice, that we want to spend more time with it. Allahu Akbar, you cannot marry your phone, my brother. You cannot marry your phone, my sister. Subhanallah, put it aside, go to sleep. You will get up the following morning, you won't know why you're depressed. When you're eating, your mouth, there is an odor from your mouth and your stomach is churning and you don't know why. Well, you did not sleep correctly. Your eyes are red, bloodshot, you don't know why. People think you're on drugs, you're not on a drug, that drug. You're on another drug, known as looking too much at the screen. Really, take it out. Make sure you know what's going on. Have limits. Set yourself, this is my sleeping time and I will sleep here at this particular time. You might want to allow yourself a 10-minute leeway, but don't get carried away. No matter what, it can wait. How many times do people go and check and refresh their pages? Oh, refresh the page. Why? I want to see what happened. Woo! He actually said he likes it. Mashallah. What's that? Subhanallah, you're getting so excited, more than when your husband tells you he loves you. You say, oh, you're just lying to me. You didn't take me out yesterday. Come on, look at this. The people whom you're living with, who mean the world to you, they're supposed to. You find fault in them because they are right in front of you. And there's this flawless person, according to you, who actually has more flaws than your own husband or your own wife. But because they are only showing you that which seems to be the good side of them, you can't see the bad side. I know of people who have divorced their spouses in order to marry someone they've met online, and after they married, then they come back and say, guess what? Biggest mistake of my life. This person is a million times worse than the husband I had before. But guess what? Some other lucky woman has got him, and he's happily gone, he's continued, and he's out. And you're the one who's stuck. Why? Because you couldn't control yourself. That's all. You didn't understand the deception of the social media. You know, social media, like we said from the very beginning, it has its positive and its negative. The sad reality is a lot of us are getting stuck with the negatives because we're still too excited about discovering what it's all about. So you see, hey, they've got this app. Did you use it? Oh, I haven't used it. It tells you who is right in this hall right now. What do you need to know that for? What do you need to know that for? Yes, if you'd like to come, mashallah, to a talk and you want to create, for example, an awareness or a page to say, who's going, I need a lift and so on, then alhamdulillah. But today people have this habit where you will go out with your friends, but you leave your wife at home. Come on, who's more important? You go out with your friends and you leave your wife at home? I don't know why you're looking at me so hard. Maybe some of us have done that already here. But really, you go out with your friends. I mean, come on, who comes first here? Your wife comes first. They can call you a chicken. They can call you whatever they want. I'd rather be a happy chicken than to be a depressed turkey. Allahu Akbar. I'd rather be a happy chicken, having been called a chicken, but I'm so delighted every day. Back, 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 back. Alhamdulillah, so what? MashaAllah. But at the same time, a person who's just, everyone thinks he's macho, you know, he's the guy, he's the don, you know. But his life is in a mess. What's the point? His friends are impressed, but his spouse is not. May Allah help us strike the balance. We are not saying divorce your friends, but we are saying when you marry, they become secondary. Inshallah, tomorrow we're going to talk about that. They become secondary. Yes, they do. They become secondary. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness and ease. So my brothers and sisters, let us use this social media and technology and our phones and laptops and whatever else we have to learn the deen, to correct our tajweed, to correct our recitation, to join Islamic universities or whatever else we have on there, to join schools, to join some learning, you know, something to do with learning, to benefit ourselves. Come on, Allah will question you. Some people have already done it. A lot of people have done it. Subhanallah. They have benefited. They have changed their lives because of how they use YouTube and how they use the internet. You know, there are some people who say, don't ever go on in the internet to find out about your deen. That also is another extreme, because sometimes the, you know, the access you have to a scholar is through the internet sometimes. So we are saying you may go on it, but disciplined, you know your lines. If you are in doubt, ask those who are real life people. What do you think of this? Get an opinion and then you may continue. Subhanallah, this particular talk of ours is being beamed across the globe live, mashallah. The brothers and sisters who are watching, may Allah bless you. And those who will be watching it later, may Allah bless you too. Those who will be seeing it perhaps after I'm dead, may Allah bless us all and make it a means of our entry into Jannah. But it's there. So people are using technology in the right direction. Subhanallah, we are being left out. Why? Because we are still busy discovering what the sites are all about, the friends. You know what? Come on, it's enough. It's enough. Live a real life. Don't live a fake life. Don't live a life that is photoshopped. No, have the real life. Because in real life, there is no photoshopping. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us and may He open our doors. My brothers and sisters, I've only spoken on a few aspects of social media. Previously, I've spoken on different aspects of social media. So if we have heard the previous talks and today's talk, it's more of a follow-up. And now technology is progressing. Things are becoming easier. More and more people are using technology. Even the older people are embracing WhatsApp for the first time. I know of some older people who refuse to use anything besides a Nokia 3110 and a Nokia 6110. Do you remember those? See all the old people saying yes, because they've got them in their pockets, mashallah. We respect you for that. But there are some who have now gone beyond that and they've said, look, it's becoming cheap. It's free to message each other. You know, you have a little WhatsApp bundle. In my country, there's a WhatsApp bundle. You pay $3 and do what you like for the whole month. Wow, subhanallah. That's amazing. WhatsApp bundle. But it doesn't mean that you need to be so typical that because it's free, you abuse the system. You know, some people have a problem. When something is free, they become so typical that they want it. Allahu Akbar. Allah, they want it. You know, I recall, in fact, let's not give that example, but perhaps we can give you another example. When phones back at home, they said, you know, landline was losing because of the internet and because of the phone. So they said, okay, landline to landline, 59 minutes free. Free. So you pay your monthly subscription, and if you're calling another landline, it's free, 59 minutes. So, you know, those who've got nothing better to do, they would phone, speak for 59 minutes, 58, they put an alarm. They say, hang on, I'll phone you back in 2 minutes. Put the phone down, pick it up again and dial again. Come on, you're abusing the system. You don't need to talk about everything. You don't need to talk so much. Make the dhikr of Allah. It's better for you. Praise Allah. Oh Allah, I love you. Say it in English. Say it in any language. Oh Allah, you are the greatest. Oh Allah, I love you. Oh Allah, help me to develop a link with you. Oh Allah, protect me from evil. Oh Allah, strengthen me so I stay away from bad. Oh Allah, strengthen me so that I can fulfill my duties unto you. Oh Allah, make me a better person. Oh Allah, make me such that the day I die, I'm the closest I ever was to you. And oh Allah, have mercy on me. Grant me Jannah. Grant me the intercession of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Allah, help me. Bless me. Grant me goodness. Grant my family goodness. My children. Talk to Allah. Imagine how much I just said in less than a minute. Imagine if we were to speak to Allah for 1 hour. A lot of us would probably say, I don't know what to say. But with Allah, the beauty is you repeat the thing. You repeat it. If you say Subhanallah, you don't just say it once. You say it a lot of times. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us. Really. So use it correctly. It does not mean that the thing is free. That you just need to use it to sin. It's become so cheap. To sin, really. So free. But if you look at it, the other side, the flip side, it's become equally cheap. Or should I say, when I say cheap here, I'm not talking of cheaply, I'm talking about that which is cost-free. It has become cost-free to do good deeds as well. You can do a lot of good deeds. So many beautiful messages, lovely clips, mashallah. People are sending reminders to one another. Reminder, my brother, do good. My sister, do good. Mashallah, tabarakallah. You have the daily reminder. You have so many other different platforms. Mashallah. You have the hadith of a day. If you, whatever you want, you can see, you can listen. Different people use different platforms for different reasons. Select those who are doing good. And subhanallah, benefit from them, if that's the case. And share it with others. Don't just be, you know, miserly and have that only for yourself. Share it with others and you will see by the will of Allah, your heart will be at peace and ease. Why? You were disciplined. You understood the values you are supposed to live by on and off social media. And you gave value to the real life people over those who were distant. You know, in Islam, there is a ruling. If I'm talking to someone, you are not allowed to come in and just butt in without permission. Did you know that? If I'm talking to you, it is disrespectful for a third party to come and say, just butt in and take over the discussion. That's very bad. So imagine today we allow a phone. Really, we're sitting on the table, and I've watched this at a restaurant. People went, hey, let's go out to eat. Okay, let's go out to eat. Everyone's on their phones. What are you? We don't know. Just watch them. You can take a photo of them. They won't notice. They're all on their phones, each one. All on their phones. And then one guy says, what are we having to eat? He says, just choose. He says, it's okay. What, you were here to talk. You were here to get together. A meal is a social event that is very valuable. Very, very high in value. Subhanallah. And here you are just on your phone. And now they've got a new one. I don't know if you've seen it. We're going for a meal, guys. All of us. Let's go. So everyone's gone. They say, put your phones in a stack. First person to pick his phone pays the bill. And guess what? Wise Jack comes with another phone in his pocket. Allahu Akbar. He comes with another phone. So his phone is there, but he's still on his phone. May Allah forgive us. Really, if people have to think that up, it means there's a problem. Put it down. Meal time, turn your phone off. The world can wait. Honestly. Right now, I'm speaking to you. My phone is in my pocket recording this. As soon as it's over, I'll try and push it up on the net, inshallah. Muslim Central Audio, by the will of Allah. It's on flight mode because I don't want it to ring. Imagine it rings here and I say, hello guys, hello, hello, hello. I can't hear you, try again. Hello, hello, put the phone. How would you feel? You'd think this man is mad, he's crazy. But to be honest, a lot of people are doing that and they're not crazy. They're just overtaken. They're intoxicated by technology. That's what happens. You become, you somehow, you lose your senses. Take it easy, put the brake on. You've got the latest vehicle, mashallah. It doesn't mean you just drive at full speed. You've got to slow down and stop. There's a red traffic light. Come on. And my brothers and sisters, the worst thing you could do, may Allah forgive me, forgive us all. The worst thing you could ever do is to be on your phone texting whilst driving. You are putting the lives of others at risk. You are committing murder. They might call it culpable homicide. But to be honest with you, you are guilty of doing something haram in the Sharia because you cannot drive and text at the same time. It is impossible, totally impossible. Something somehow will happen. And I'm sure those of you who have tried it, myself included, I told you Allah forgive me, didn't I start with that? May Allah forgive us all. We need discipline. And this is why I'm talking to you. We share things in order to encourage us to do the right thing. That's what it's all about. So I recall, I try to text and I look up and before, you know, you got to slam the brake or you got to make a quick turn, you're lucky. That was Allah telling you, hey, the next time you might go straight into there. Allahu Akbar. May Allah help us. My brothers and sisters, beautiful topic. We can continue inshallah, but perhaps next time we might have new technology to be speaking about and we might be speaking about new things. Today we've just spoken about a little bit. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us, make us from amongst those who can protect ourselves from the evil of social media. May He make us use it in the right direction. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Subhanallah bihamdih. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka.